Your eyes are open, so never close them. You'll sail the ocean fine.
This team is like our second family.
We're also very excited for this new experience.
It's going to be extremely bittersweet. It's going to be really tough.
You always bring something new, you know?
So close, and I love them all very much.
It's a different feeling when you do other sports and then you look at dance, because what is negative?
Scared to drop this album. Let's push it back another week. I wanna be next to forever. Find a way to never hit my peak. I'm kinda scared of graduation. Cause who am I when this is done? I wanna be next to forever.
Forever. I'll be second.
Yeah. No tricks, only choreo.
We gotta stay
so much. You better.
And then drop back down.
Right now we're just working on perfecting the little details, because we practically have our whole routine done and we just want to make sure every little thing is perfect and like well put together.
Like, we're like to the point like this routine looks so good from where it was until like where it is now. Like I feel like it's like nationals is like so like close, and we're gonna be like ready, and like when we get on that stage, like everything's gonna like come into place, and like no one's gonna like see us coming.
It's a tight space, so we don't have all the room that we can use, and in our like formations are very like spread out, so it makes things even harder, and it's harder to do like some of our tricks since we do like stunts and stuff, so it's pretty hard for that.
So practice leading up to nationals was really, really tough. I think this year, compared to last year, we probably put in even more hours, just because we didn't have any snow days leading up to NDA, so that gave us more time to practice. We also put in a lot more time into conditioning our bodies, strengthening, strength training, and also endurance training. I would say that the number of like squats and push-ups and planks and everything else that we do for strength training probably more than tripled the amount that we did last year. As far as our endurance training went, we were running almost like close to 10 miles a week for, you know, leading up to nationals. And just because we needed to be at our best. The routine that we had this year was probably one of our most physically demanding routines. So it was definitely very necessary for us to be in our best shape.
Yeah, but we're also very excited for this new experience, because this is something that we've never gotten to do before. Like, this is a huge competition, and we also get to travel and like go to Florida with all of like our like best friends. As like they've said, that our team is so close. So I'm really excited to get this experience in, and I think, I mean, I'm obviously very nervous. I think all of us are. I think the whole team is. But like, yeah, we're all very excited.
We're all excited.
Yeah.
I think we're on a good road to nationals. We have a really awesome routine, and it's just going to get better. We're going to add things, we're going to fix things, so many things for nationals, and it's just going to get better. And we also have amazing stunts and tricks that we normally don't have this early on in competition season, which is really awesome, so that gives me hope also.
I do believe that our team is ready for NDA. I think that this team, we have a big variety of like choreo and tricks, and so I feel like we're gonna bring something completely different to NDA this year that we've never ever done before.
For nationals this year, I'm definitely super excited because of how we did last year. I definitely wanna keep that up and keep our train going forward, try to get all the momentum we can going into nationals. On our last two competitions, we placed first, which is definitely little head of steam, so I'm definitely super excited. I think we have a good routine. I think we're going to do fairly well. But I gotta go so much bigger, so they can never shut me down. I'm kind of scared of graduation, because who am I when this is done? I want to be next to so the best is always here to come. Someday they'll be talking about me. Right now they're just walking around. Be talking about me. Somebody help me. Somebody help me. Someday they'll be talking about me. Right now they're just walking around me. Someday they'll be talking about me. Somebody help me. Should I keep it light? Stay out of the fight. No one's gonna listen.
So the trip down there was a little different. I think that we're so used to going to a particular venue. For the past 9 years, we were going to Universal Studios. So I felt that it was definitely a different feeling just heading over to a completely different venue, not being able to like go by the things that we're used to seeing and doing, whether that be practice areas or just the things that we would normally experience. Definitely made me miss like the other venue a lot, just because we had so many memories as a team at the original venue. And, you know, having 9 years at the same place and knowing what to expect, like it is hard to like all of a sudden completely just, you know, change that, so. Like an 18,
yeah, we've been doing music. Can you guys like have that performance factor right now? Like with your face and like your attitude, like work it. We do this tomorrow, okay?
Now, it's going to be extremely bittersweet. It's gonna be really tough. I know I'm gonna cry, just because I feel like I don't know life without NDA right now, because that's everything that dance has been leading up to. Like every single year of high school, it's always dance has led up to NDA, and it's gonna be a lot of pressure going off of last year, attempting to maintain our national champion title. But it's gonna be, I think, I'm confident in our abilities, but emotionally it's gonna be tough.
So at Nationals, usually what we did freshman year and the years before that, they would have a park day and then they would go towards practicing for prelims, and then they'd go into prelims and then hopefully finals, and then another park day at the end. But last year we changed it around a little bit and we started off practicing and we started off preparing for prelims, and then we were in that like hardworking mindset. So I feel like with that mindset, we were able to work our butts off until we were able to get to prelims and get to finals and then win. And then even after winning, we were on that high. So going to the parks right afterwards as like a winning team and as like a team that bonded over winning as well was just such an amazing thing to do.
When you guys go 1, 2, 3, 4, there's a little pause and then it goes.
We gon' burn the whole house down. usually have this tradition where we go out to fancy night where we dress up, look nice, and we just spend the night together. Win or lose, we're just there for each other.
So fancy night this year ended up being, I think it was like a ballroom downstairs from the front lobby. So it was different from what we're normally used to, because fancy night in the past would be at the Hard Rock Cafe, which was next to the Hard Rock Live, which was the original venue. So this year it was definitely fun just having like a chance to like dress up with the team. But it definitely also made me miss like having our usual fancy night dinner at the Hard Rock Cafe.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. And the rumpus and ruckus are comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
So we're just kind of feeding off of each other's energies. But I know, like, you know, sometimes you can see that and then you get discouraged. You're like, oh my god, like, that's intimidating, right?
That's but, not an option anymore.
But you guys
we're here already.
See that, and you guys are letting that, like, bring in even more energy and more fierceness into what you guys are doing.
So, I think I'm feeling pretty good. Right now we're at 11 p.m. and we've been practicing all day long. But, you know, we've made a lot of good improvements throughout today, especially on the practice floor earlier today. The team looked really strong. I think they feel really confident. You know, tricks were hitting, and just, you know, overall intensity, synchronicity, everything was like, I felt really on point. So right now it's just a matter of just how much they, you know, want to push, and you know, as long as they want to push, we're gonna push with them. So yeah.
1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
We're gonna go into the little bend into the
Gawara. 6, 7, 8.
Do it in place for now.
I think right now we're definitely in, you know, a good position to do well in prelims. I don't see anything that's causing me like, or making me feel like any concern about prelims, but it's really tough. We always want to go in just trying our best. We don't want to, you know, assume that we will do well. It's just, we know, like, we've been training for this, we put in the work, and the best we can do is just, you know, control what we can't control, which is our own routine. And as long as they're confident in their own routine, they're confident on with each other and their teammates, then I think we're gonna do well. So
waking up after our first day at NDA, I was definitely very excited. I think that with the amount of time that we put into practices, I felt that we were ready. For me, I think that with that excitement also came with nerves, just like any other competition. No matter how prepared you are, I feel like you're always gonna feel that nervous energy. But if anything, I think that the team did a really good job. It was really nice just kind of feeding off of each other's energy, even though some of us were more nervous than others.
A text, and she wants me to read it to you guys. Oh my god, it's prelims day! I can't believe the time is here and you have all worked so hard to get to this point. I have no doubt that you will all kill it on stage and leave the judges speechless. You guys are amazing and always keep your heads up. The only piece of advice I have is to leave everything on the stage and love every second of it. I'm y'all's biggest fan and I'm rooting for you more than anything. The work is worth it. DHSDT for life. Kill it.
Gonna puke, cause my taxes are due. Do my password begin with a 1 or a 2? Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
metronome.
Man, I'm up to something. Ooh dee la dee do, thank you all for coming. I hope you like the show, cause it's on a budget. So ooh dee la dee do.
Okay, so I think a lot of people, based off of pictures and things that you see like on social media and everything, it's easy to believe that Dance Team goes to nationals and it's more of a vacation and a trip, but it's definitely 99% practicing, and it's hard work, and it's sweating, and it is being exhausted. And the night before finals, we actually stayed up until about 2 a.m. outside in a random parking lot, and we were practicing for a solid 5 or 6 hours. And even though in the grand scheme of things that sounds like so much, but it's also so worth it when it all pays off in the end. And you never know what's gonna happen, so all you can do is prepare as best as you can. And we really did that this past year.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. Yeah, you guys are standing completely. You just popped up. Cause you dropped back down on 3, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Don't forget all the details. 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Try again. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Move. 5, 6, 7, 8,
hold. So practices leading up to our first performance, I would say that they went really well, just because I feel that our leadership group this year, they've done such a good job with just keeping the team together. And not having Claire there with me, you know, I think that it was more apparent how much like we needed our leadership group to just be strong for the team, and just to help, you know, keep things running smoothly, keep everybody's spirit high, just keep everybody, you know, calm and focused.
So put your best face on, everybody pretend you know this song, everybody come hang, let's go out with a bang.
This is an open hand. I swear to God, if I have to tell y'all open hand again, open hand is expanding all of your fingers. This is not an open hand. This is a lazy hand. This is an open hand. There's a difference. Okay? Freshmen, I'm mainly saying this to you because I've told y'all multiple times. This is an open hand.
All right. Bases for the pyramid. So the flyers are gonna go up, bang, down, flip, and reverse it. You guys keep your hands on there, and then as soon as you hear the rewind, you guys let go, okay?
You guys right now, the energy you're bringing, like nobody's holding back wherever they are in this routine. And you guys, like you guys are selling it, and you're not even facing me. I'm watching this routine from behind, and it looks really good.
Go!
Got it? You guys know what to do. Okay? Kill it. Perform like you've never performed before. You don't get another chance, okay? This is your one time. Kill it. You guys deserve to kill it.
You act dumb like, duh. You act dumb like, duh. Ta 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 ta. Check me so good I say. Work it, need a glass of water. Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my thing down, flip it in reverse. If you're feminine, stay in with me. If you're feminine, stay in with me.
Haters wanna fight me, yeah, he's mad, cause I came up overnight, me. Yeah, I switched it up, I got a 9-cup tight, me. So you better do the right.
After we had performed prelims, you know, I remember us being led over to another room where we were able to review our footage, and they had somebody to do vocal critiques for us. And, you know, when we were going through our footage, I felt really good. I felt really good about our prelims performance. But also, I think that we were able to see a lot of our nerves. I could tell that the nerves were getting to some of our dancers, and we were not as clean, or we didn't execute as well as we were on the practice floor right beforehand. And so those things were definitely apparent after our prelims performance. You know, one of the judges that I remember that gave us critiques was talking about, you know, our uniformity, our tricks not hitting the way that it should have hit. Things that I think we could see from just watching our routine footage. So a lot of the things that the judges were saying made a lot of sense. Maybe also the way that we had performed some of our visuals and just like choreography. There was just something kind of missing from maybe just the way that it was not only executed, but just the way that it was performed. A lot of things that I think we knew that we could take and work on. Overall, being in prelims at, I think it was in sixth place in prelims. The team had really high expectations beforehand, but, you know, we knew going into it, whatever we were gonna place, we did everything we could to make sure, like, we had a chance to move on to finals.
I've been so good, I've been helpful and friendly. I've been so good, why am I feeling empty? I've been so good, I've been so good this year.
Hey. Five, six, seven, eight.
I've been so good.
Yes. Nice.
she didn't know what to do, so she jumped in front of me.
I would say one of our greatest strengths would be our positivity. We're always hyping each other up, each other going, and we're just there for each other. That's pretty great. And I would say weakness would be like before we get distracted a lot, but we always find a way to push through.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1.
Watch coming in the pan!
10, 10, 10, 10, 10.
As an officer, I think there's a lot of things that happen behind the scenes that a lot of people don't realize that go on, but from our perspective, especially with our nationals routine, we think about every single little detail. Everything that you see on the stage, we have at least thought about 100 times. And we just have to figure out, formation-wise, like to get an even mix of who's in the front and in the back. We have to make transitions seamless. We have to make visuals appealing. And we have to make sure the tricks go smoothly. So there's a lot of things that require a lot of work. And I'm really proud of this team of officers because we have killed it this year. And we work really hard and we put our team first, which is the most important.
The practice after prelims, I think I remember we took a break to just get some food, just to, you know, decompress for a little bit. But we regrouped like probably not even an hour after we left that floor. For us, we knew that there was another chance that we had. Making it to finals was our first step, but from there, like, we knew that we had another chance to, like, make this even better. I think that things were a little tough because with the team that's half vets and half rookies, there's a lot of pressure that was put on the rookies just because, you know, they know the standard was set so high from the year before and they didn't want to disappoint the rest of the team. And so I think after leaving the prelims floor, it was only natural, I think, to start having doubts in your mind, just to feel like unsure about finals. But I remember we did regroup and we had this talk before we started practicing. It was a pretty, I would say, emotional like meeting with the team, just because I think that everybody felt that they could have done more.
So right now, just go ahead and head back. We'll text out more details.
There's a little timing issues right now, but it's because we just did it, right? So if we work on this and get this down, it's going to look really good.
I think being a guy on a predominantly female team is a lot of fun because it just gives us so many like opportunities to like have like, because we get looked at a lot more, which can be kind of scary, but at the same time it can be like really cool because when we have our own little guys part, everyone like usually goes crazy, so we can usually make really fun, playful like choreography that like really goes along with like the crowd, and everyone's like, oh, the boys are gonna come, they're gonna get really hype. So I think it just gives us more of a chance to like really like show off our talent and also just bring a little extra like flair to the routine.
I think I faced a couple of challenges because definitely like when we go to camp, we're the only team that has guys, but while it's super fun, there is like a lot of pressure on just being one of four guys, like that's it. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of a predominantly hip hop. And then when we start to go into the contemporary and the lyrical, it definitely gets a little difficult because we're not really used to that. Even if you were a girl, it's kind of easier, I would say, but there's definitely a little bit of pressure being one of four guys.
During school, I
people ask me, like, are all the guys on the team gay or something like that, just because they think that when guys do dance, they're gay. I feel like also one of the adversities for me is also flexibility, because at training camp, at training camp, when we do warm-ups and everyone else is doing stretches, I can't do splits.
Come outside, come outside. You fell, but now you're high. You've been outside, so go ahead and do it one more time. Come outside, come outside. You went hard and you did fine. You've been outside, so go ahead and do it one more time.
So I remember going to the practice floor right before finals, walking in there and running through our tricks, running through, you know, our routine. I felt the overall feeling was that the team felt confident. You know, they were hitting their tricks, they were hitting pretty much everything that we had changed and thrown at them the night before.
I just want to say I'm so proud of you guys. Like, you look so good. Like, you guys killed it.
Don't make us cry.
Thank you. Thank you. Like, I needed that. Thank you. Every single one of you guys. Keep it up.
You know, leaving the practice floor, going backstage, I think any time there's like room to breathe or room to like take a second, those times can sometimes be maybe of a disadvantage, because when you're not doing something or you're just kind of waiting, I think in those moments, like, that's a true test of whether, like, your mind's gonna, you know, be your friend or your enemy.
They want it, they want it.
You act dumb like duh. You act dumb like duh. Ta 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 ta. Check me so good I say. Work it. Another glass of water. Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my thing down, flip it in reverse. It's your feminine to stay here with the. It's your feminine to stay here with the.
Like me, haters wanna fight me. Yeah, he's mad, cause I came up overnight. Me, yeah, I switched it up, I got a 9-cup tight. Me, so you better do the right.
Jay, what I need a beat, I can't go off.
This Sally Walker walking down the street. She didn't know what to do, so she jumped in front of me. I said, gone, girl, do your thing, do your thing, do your thing. Gone, girl, do your thing, stop. Do your thing, drop, go, lock, lock, lock.
Look it up,
Yo te pongo loca, look at this. Tipo así.
Bolas de bolas de bolas, bolas de bolas de bolas, bolas de bolas de bolas, bolas de bolas.
So performing at finals, I would say that one of the things that I always remind everybody as a coach is to leave everything on that floor. You don't want to perform where you're going to look back at it and wish you could have done more. And I think that was really how I felt our finals performance went, that the amount of just energy that was on that stage, the amount of energy that the dancers gave out, just everything that was hitting, like, I truly felt that we, as a team, did everything we could. Like, we literally just left everything on that floor, and we couldn't have done any more.
Come outside, you went hard, and you did fight. You've been outside, been outside, so go ahead and do it one time.
In fifth place with an 89.67, Dominion High School!
But happy for you guys, because I know how much you worked for that, okay? So you go home and you are proud of that fifth place that you bought back for Dominion. So thank you guys so much.
So it's always tough every year to like lose our dancers, and you know, we had three seniors this year. Two of them have been with us all 4 years. The other one was with us for three. And there's so many memories that they've made on this team, and just seeing their journey from, you know, their first year to their senior year, like, I'm so, just so proud of everything they've done. On top of that, you know, Connor, leaving this year, which we were blessed to just have him for one more year. He's also going to be truly missed, and for him, he had to leave on a flight 5 a.m. the next morning after, you know, everything had ended. So for me, that made it hit even harder. It's always hard for me as a coach to like lose people, whether it's from graduation or just, you know, if they decide to leave the team. And so I know it's going to hit me harder as it gets closer to its end of the school year, but I think NDA is one of those events where we look forward to so much, like from beginning of the year, that it kind of feels like the end of our season. So I remember being at NDA, and then when we had our moment to kind of reflect back on the weekend, we definitely had an emotional moment.
I'm definitely going to come back and visit whenever I can, just to keep in touch with my roots and where I came from and where this all started. But I do plan on going to BCU Arts College and hopefully joining Blank Canvas, their hip-hop dance team over there. So.
My plans after My plans after high school. Well, I'm gonna do NOAA for 2 years, and then hopefully get into Virginia Tech. That's like what I'm aiming for, and then be a part of their dance team called Bamboo. So while I'm at NOAA for 2 years, I will definitely be here a lot, like visiting every competition, supporting as much as I can. And I was like literally thinking like, a couple minutes ago, like, what am I gonna do? Like, my life revolved around dancing so much. Like, everything was dance, school, dance, school, dance, school. Like, there was nothing else. And I don't know what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna miss them a lot. So, yeah. My plans after high school are Nova for 2 years, and I'm looking towards George Mason or Virginia Tech. I as well want to join Bamboo at Virginia Tech. But while I'm at Nova, I'm definitely going to be back with Sarah, watching them at every competition, football game.
Oh God!
Don't run away!
Well, what threw them off before is that. So now
I don't want to be in it.
Do you have Barbie and the Pearl Princess?
Are you marrying me?
Yes.
Mr. K for newlyweds!
Catch my breath, let me catch my. I can't remember how I got here. Can you wait a sec? Let me catch my breath, let me catch my. I can't remember how I got here, got here. They wanted heaven from me, I gave them hell. Now they want something bigger, I'm overwhelmed. I think it's time to go now. I think my curtain's falling. Just don't forget about me.